गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एब्डोमिनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। सो वी हैव द प्रेजेंटेशन एंड यू कैन सी गो थ्रू द स्लाइड्स। सो ट्यूबरकुलोसिस इज अ कॉमन डिसीज इन इंडिया एंड अदर डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज। द एक्स्ट्रापल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस व्हिच इन्वॉल्व्स द एब्डोमिनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड अदर डिसीज कंसिस्ट ऑफ 11-16% ऑफ पेशेंट्स, आउट ऑफ व्हिच 3-4% बिलोंग टू द एब्डोमिनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। एब्डोमिनल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस इज द सिक्स्थ मोस्ट कॉमन टाइप ऑफ एक्स्ट्रापल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। So this is the slide showing total cases of tuberculosis. Out of 100, is almost 82.5% is pulmonary tuberculosis, while 17.5% is extrapulmonary tuberculosis. Of the extrapulmonary tuberculosis, most common is nowadays there is a very high impact of HIV co-infection with tuberculosis, and with increasing incidence of HIV, the infection, there is increase in both incidence of severity of extrapulmonary tuberculosis and the incidence of tuberculosis. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis alone or in association with pulmonary disease has been documented in 40-60% of all cases. HIV coexistence has dramatically changed the etiological agents and the pattern of presentation of abdominal tuberculosis, thus producing diagnostic difficulties to the medical fraternity. So the etiological factor, that is Mycobacterium tuberculi, is a family consisting of Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Mycobacterium bovis, Africanum, then microti, Mycobacterium canetti, Mycobacterium caprae and pinnipedi, etc. So the pathophysiology of abdominal tuberculosis, either it is a primary infection or a secondary infection. Abdominal tuberculosis results from ingestion of milk or food infected with Mycobacterium bovis, which has, nowadays it has been almost obsolete, or it is a very, very rare disease. The secondary pathogen comes, is the pathogen in most of the cases. Mycobacterium tuberculosis is a slight, morphologically, it is slightly curved, rod shaped bacilli, 0.5 to 0.5 microns in diameter and 2 to 4 microns in length. It is acid fast that resists decolorization with acid or alcohol. It is multiplies slowly, that is every 18 to 24 hours. There is a thick lipid cell wall, and it can remain dormant for decades. It is aerobic disease and non-motile. The modes of transmission: dissemination of primary pulmonary tuberculosis in childhood, which leads to swallowing of infected sputum in active pulmonary tuberculosis, and the hematogenous spread, then through lymphatics, spread from infected adjacent organs like fallopian tubes, and dissemination through bile from tubercular granulomas of the liver. Pathology: bacilli in depth of mucosal glands cause inflammatory reaction, and there is a phagocytes which carry bacilli to pierce patches, and there is formation of tubercle, and tubercles undergo necrosis. enlarge, and endarteritis and edema occurs. There is sloughing and ulcer formation, accumulation of collagenous tissue, and there is thickening and stenosis of the bowel lumen. The inflammatory process in some mucosa penetrates to the serosa. The tubercles on serosa surface, there is bacilli, rich lymph nodes, and bacilli where the lymphatics cause lymphatic obstruction of mesentery and bowel wall. There is a thick fixed mass and regional lymph nodes, that is hyperplasia. Then there is in the lymph nodes there is caseation and necrosis, and in some it occurs calcification occurs. The sites of involvement: gastrointestinal tract, most commonly involved, it can involve any part of GI tract from mouth to anus. But peritoneum, lymph nodes, and solid organs like liver, spleen, pancreas, omentum are also involved. But the mostly 70 to 78% of abdominal tuberculosis consists of gastrointestinal tuberculosis, and the most common site is ileocecal region. Why it is so common? Because there is stasis, abundant pears patches, and there is alkaline media. Bacterial contact time is more, and there is minimal digestive activity in the ileocecal region, and there is maximum absorption in that area. So tubercle bacilli and other products are also absorbed there. Characteristic lesions produced are ulcerative or hypertrophic, then stricturous or constrictive diffuse colitis. Combination of these forms can also occur. These are the types of lesions. Then ulcerative type: adult patients who are malnourished, multiple circumferential transverse ulcers, that is girdle ulcers with skip lesions are occur, and it's also called as napkin ring structures in long standing ulcers. The hyperplastic type, they allow the volume infection by less virulent organisms in a host of good resistance and wound healing capacity. Chronic granulomatous lesions in ileocecal region, fibroblastic activity in submucosa and subserosa causes thickening of the bowel wall with lymph node enlargement. There is stricturous type, causes strictures, and they may be multiple or single. Diffuse colitis, it is a rare form, very similar to tubercular colitis, ulcerative colitis. These are the structures are shown as the ulcers, and in between the skip areas are also seen. And esophageal tuberculosis, it is a very rare, usually occurs due to direct extension from adjacent structures. Gastric tuberculosis is rare, and 80% of patients have ulcerative form. And duodenal tuberculosis is again rare, and usually involvement is obstructive type, that is from extrinsic to liminal. And anal perianal ulcerative lesions, fistula in ano, perianal abscess are seen. Peritoneal tuberculosis occurs in 4 to 10% of patients of extrapulmonary tuberculosis. It follows either direct spread of tuberculosis from ruptured lymph nodes or intra-abdominal organs, or hematogenous spread. Then abdominal lymph node and peritoneal tuberculosis may occur without gastrointestinal involvement about 1/3 of cases. Then a occurs in 4 to 10 patients of extrapulmonary tuberculosis is followed by the direct spread of tuberculosis from ruptured lymph node. We have to cover it. Okay. Peritoneal tuberculosis. Peritoneal tuberculosis can occur in two forms, that is acute, it mimics the acute abdomen due to perforation of or rupture of mesenteric lymph nodes, and it's chronic, it is ascites or encysted lymphoblastic and it can be purulent also. So, peritoneal tuberculosis, ascitic type, it extends intense exudate, causes ascites, it is common in children and young adults, and it can be encysted type also. Exudation with minimal fibroblastic reaction, there is ascitic gates located due to fibrinous deposition. Peritoneal tuberculosis. The plastic type with a motor made of this. The motor actually. Actually, it's small. Tuberculosis lymphadenitis accounts for about 25% of cases of extrapulmonary tuberculosis in abdomen. Mainly it is mesenteric, peripancreatic, periportal, upper portal aortic group of lymph nodes. You know, lymph node may show caseation or calcification. Tuberculous mesenteric lymphadenitis, it's 5 types of lymph node involvement seen, right? Acute mesenteric lymphadenitis, pseudo mesenteric cyst, tabus mesenterica, chronic lymphadenitis, and calcified lesion. Solid organ tuberculosis, involvement of liver and spleen occurs as a part of disseminated and miliary tuberculosis. Clinical manifestations. Disease may present at any age but commonly seen in young adults with slight female predominance. In children, peritoneal and nodal form of tuberculosis is more common than intestinal tuberculosis. It may present as acute disease or chronic illness or an acute or chronic event. The symptoms, constitutional symptoms or dull lymph nodes are involved. Clinical presentations of abdominal tuberculosis. One is type, depends on the type. Ulcerative type causes clinical presentation, chronic diarrhea, malabsorption, intestinal perforation, occasional, and rectal bleeding is rare, but reported occasionally in chronic colonic tuberculosis. Then second is hypertrophic, that the intestinal obstruction or an abdominal ileocecal lump can be presented. Then strictures or constrictive type causes recurrent subacute intestinal obstruction, example vomiting, constipation, distension of and colicky pain. There may be associated gurgling sounds or feeling of moving ball or ball of wind in abdomen and visible distended intestinal loops with visual peristalsis. The symptoms get relieved with passage of platelets or stool, and sometimes acute intestinal obstruction may develop. Then anorectal, the restricture of fistula in ano. Then gastroduodenal, that is peptic ulcer with or without gastric outlet obstruction or perforation. Liver and spleen, hepatosplenomegaly usually as a part of Partial of disseminated tuberculosis is accompanied with fewer night sweats and decreased or loss of appetite when microscopy involvement shows granulomatous hepatitis. When peritoneum abdominal distension and ascites, sometimes there may be a soft cystic lump due to localized ascites. Lymph nodes as mass of lump or matted lymph nodes. Then complications. The complications are intestinal obstruction, then most common complication, then mechanism is hyperplastic intestinal lesion or strictures, adhesion or adjacent lymph nodes involvement. Malabsorption, blind loop syndrome, most important causes of malabsorption in India next to the tropical sprue. Then perforation occurs, second most common cause of small intestinal perforation, first being typhoid fever. Usually single or proximal to the stricture. Then disseminated tuberculosis, cold abscess formation, hemorrhage, fecal fistula, gastric outlet obstruction. The abdominal tuberculosis may mimic any of the following conditions, then malignant neoplasms, lymphoma, carcinoma, inflammatory bowel disease, Crohn's disease. Then ascites, hepatic, cardiac, renal, malignant, ileocecal mass, appendicular lump, CA sickle, malabsorption syndromes. Diagnosis. The key is high degree of suspicion with proper use of diagnostic modalities. The new criteria of diagnosis were suggested by Lingenfelser's as follows. Clinical features suggestive of tuberculosis, then imaging evidence of indicative of abdominal tuberculosis, that is histopathological or microbiological evidence of tuberculosis and or therapeutic response to ATT. Investigation, blood investigations, they will point out anemia, leukopenia with lymphocytosis, raised ESR, hypoalbuminemia, Mantoux test, then chest X-ray, plain X-ray abdomen. This is the plain X-ray of abdomen in this, which causes intestinal obstruction and calcified lymph nodes, then hollow viscous perforation, calcified granuloma and liver. This is ileocecal tuberculosis, radiograph obtained for peroral pneumocolon technique demonstrates a conical and shrunken cecum. Barium study, very useful for intestinal tuberculosis, small bowel barium meal follow through and barium enema for colon and ileocecal region. There is loss of normal ileocecal angle and dilated terminalium, appearing suspended from a retracted fibrous cecum, that is goose neck deformity. Loss of normal ileocecal angle and dilated terminal ileum appearing suspended from a retracted fibrous cecum, that is goose neck deformity. Barium esophagogram, ulcerative esophagitis, stricture and pseudotumor masses, fistula, virus traction. Other investigations, ultrasound abdomen, mainly used for extra intestinal lesions. Then second in colonoscopy, excellent tool for suspected colonic and terminal ileum involvement. There is mucosal nodules and ulcers are seen. CT abdomen, nowadays it is much more better and it can be a diagnostic. Diagnostic laparoscopy. It is invasive and should be used when the other measures are not. Then FNAC is also very much suggestive. Peritoneal biopsy, serodiagnosis, other investigations like blood proteins, then leukocyte count, ADA levels and PCR for MTB. ADA is an enzyme present in T lymphocytes and macrophages, hence there is level increase due to stimulation of T lymphocytes in response to CMI1A2 bacterial mycobacterial agents. Treatment. Medical management consists of first line drugs, that is ionized rifampicin, pyrazinamide and ethambutol. Second line drugs like amikacin, kanamycin, PAS, ciprofloxacin, clarithromycin, azithromycin, rifampicin, and treatment to be continued for 6 months and supportive nutrition. Role of corticosteroids used to decrease fibrosis during healing so as to prevent development of obstruction but may delay healing and predispose to perforation and further obstruction. In HIV coexistence cases, you have to give antiretroviral or HART treatment, heart treatment as well as ATT. Tuberculosis ascites with underlying cirrhosis. Then surgical management indications are intestinal obstruction, severe hemorrhage, acute abdominal perforation, and intra-abdominal abscesses, fistula or formation, and uncertain diagnosis. Then ileocecal resection with 5 cm margin, stricturoplasty, then single stricture, thriable resection, multiple strictures, resection and anastomosis. Multiple strictures with long segment, then multiple stricturoplasty. So abdominal take home message, abdominal tuberculosis is increasing with increasing incidence of HIV infection, peritoneum and ileocecal region are commonly affected, and you first exclude this treatable entity in all the patients presenting with GI disease. Antimicrobial therapy is the same for pulmonary tuberculosis. Thank you. समोर होता नहीं गया, हम लोग गला नहीं कहने।